GCAP 3056 is an award-winning general education capstone course that Ben and I co-develop and co-teach for the Language Center and the Department of English.
The course is designed to empower students to conduct research on policies and programs of the Hong Kong government, and then they share their insights by writing in the South China Morning Post letters column.
I help students to develop their research skills and to communicate their findings effectively in writing. I also help students in understanding the social issues and the role of the government policies in addressing these social issues.
I hope that I was able to open up some possible topic areas for student project work based on my own research interests in the LGBT plus community in Hong Kong and Asia. They were able to formulate convincing arguments on the need for better gender and sexuality inclusivity initiatives as a letter to the SCMP.
We also collaborated on writing letters to the editor in the South China Morning Post as a way to demonstrate to our students the kind of writing and engagement with public discourse that we expect of in the course.
And actually having the opportunity to publish an article in a leading newspaper in Hong Kong is a real highlight of the course. Students find it rewarding to have their voices heard by the community through this publication.
We also hope that students will develop the skills and confidence to engage in informed public discourse and make a difference in their community.
And we also hope that they'll actually be inspired to continue being active citizens and contribute to the public good long after the course is over.
Sustainable peace is mainly based on the emerging field of peace and conflict studies. It introduces students to theories and practical tools in peace building, with particular geographic focus on conflict dynamics in contemporary Europe and Asia. Students are expected to engage in conflict analysis and work towards conflict resolution in role play and simulation exercises. Each of them was to be paired with an online partner, and both of them were required to actively contribute to the negotiation process. The uniqueness of this method is that it maximizes the participation possibilities and the interaction intensity of both online and offline students as far as technically possible. In 2018, I received a research grant under the earlier career scheme of the Research Grants Council on a three-year project dealing with reconciliation efforts in Northern Ireland under the Belfast Agreement. The research grant had an education portion that allowed me to support two of my previous students' honors projects on Northern Ireland. And they came as experts to my class to help facilitate the simulation exercise on negotiating the Good Friday Agreement. I also used the fund to pay for an international legal expert to co-facilitate the final simulation exercise. So in multiple ways, RGC-funded research projects can actually bring learning benefits to our students directly.